Hello children, today let us discuss the first lesson, Who Did Patrick's Homework, from the text Honeysuckle. The author of this course is Annie Coral Moore. She was born on July 12, 1871 and she died on January 20, 1961. She was an American educator, a writer, an advocate for children's libraries. Before we move on to the lesson, let's discuss our views about homework. For most of us, homework is boring task. There would be a different reasons for that. It does not allow you free time. You are not able to play games, watch television, or sometimes you are overloaded with too much of work. The main character in this lesson is a young boy named Patrick. He was interested in playing games like basketball, hockey. And Nintendo. Instead, his teachers told him, "Patrick, do your homework or you won't learn a thing." And it's true. Sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus. But what could he do? He hated homework. See, in this story, the main character is the boy named Patrick. He never likes to do his homework by himself because he doesn't like the homework. He feels that it was too much of boring. Instead of that, he likes only to play basketball, hockey and Ninto. That is, a Ninto means a video game. Then one day he found his cat playing with a little dog and grabbed it away. Grabbed means that is a sudden movement. One day the boy, that is our main character Patrick, found his cat, his own cat, and that is playing with a little doll, and he grabbed it away. The cat was grabbed and he grabbed it away. To his surprise, it wasn't a doll. It was not a doll at all, but a man of tiniest size. See in the picture, see before the cat, a man is standing. That is the tiniest size. The man is in the tiniest size. He had a little wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches. See that breeches. Breeches means a short trousers. We can say as a short trousers. It's mentioned as breeches. And a high, tall hat, much like a witch's. See in the picture how the appearance of the man. He wears a little wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches. That is a trousers. And a high, tall hat. The man is wearing a hat much like a witch's. Yield, save me, but don't give me back to that cat. I will grant you a wish. I promise you that. Listen, the man who is standing in front of the cat was afraid on seeing the cat. He said, that is the tiniest size man say that, save me. That is, he asked our character Patrick to save him. Don't give me back to that cat. I will grant you a wish. See, the tiniest size man informed to the Patrick that he will give him a wish. That is, he give us a promise that surely he will do him some wish. Patrick couldn't believe how lucky he was. That is, on seeing this tiny creature and about his promise, he was so surprised that how lucky he was. He was very exclaimed. Here was the answer to all his problems. That is, what is his main problem? To do the homework by his own. It is a very big problem to our character Patrick. So he said, only if you do all my homework till the end of the semester, that's 35 days. That is, an agreement is going on between our character Patrick and the tiniest size man. That the tiniest size man wants to do all his homeworks, that is a complete till that end of the semester, that's for 35 days. If you do a good enough job, I would even get A's. That is, A's means That is, I will save you from that cat. Okay, and gentle agreement character is going on in between them. That is, the Patrick is promised to our tiniest size man that he will save him from the cat, and the tiniest man promised to Patrick that he will do the Patrick's homework till his end of the semester. That's for 35 days. The little man wrinkled like a dishcloth thrown in the hamper. The little man's face wrinkled like a dishcloth. What is the meaning of dishcloth? That is a cloth used for washing dishes. A cloth used for washing dishes thrown in the hamper. Hamper means that is a basket is covered with a lid. How the man's face was? It's like a wrinkle, like a dishcloth thrown in the hamper. He kicked his legs and doubled his fist and he grimaced and scolded and pursed his lips. Oh, I'm a curse, but I will do it. And true to his word, that little elf began to do Patrick's homework. What is the meaning of elf? Elf means a magical person who is in a small size. E-L-F, elf means it is a magical person with the tiniest size. Except there was one glitch. Glitch means that is a fault in machine that prevents it from working properly. That is a problem. The glitch means it is a problem. The elf didn't always know what to do and he needed help. The elf doesn't know what to do at the minute and he needed help. Help me, help me, he did say. And Patrick would have to help in whatever way. That is a our tiniest creature, that is the tiniest man, doesn't know how to do homework, but he accepted on behalf of this Patrick. But he needs some help, so he asked the help from our character Patrick. That is, help me, help me, he said. And Patrick would have to help in whatever way. I don't know this word, the elf squeaked while reading Patrick's homework. Get me a dictionary. No, what's even better, look up the word and sound it by each letter. The tiniest man doesn't know how to do the homework. Just he accept his argument, but he doesn't know how to do his work. He doesn't understand the meaning of the word. So he asked the help from the Patrick. That's to give him a dictionary to find the or to refer the meaning of the words. When it came to maths, Patrick was out of luck. What are times tables? The elves said. We elves never need that. That is, Patrick was out of luck. What are times tables? That is, our tiniest size man doesn't know what is meaning of tables and he never used this in his life. And addition and subtraction and division and fractions, there is nothing necessary for him to do or to learn what is the meaning of addition or subtraction or multiplication or division. Nothing is used in his life so far. Here, sit down beside me, you simply must guide me. Elves know nothing of human history, to them it's a mystery. So the little elf, already a shorter, just got louder. Go to the library, I need books, more and more books, and you can help me read them too. That is, our tiniest man doesn't know about Max anything else, so he wants our Patrick to guide him. He asked our Patrick to bring him so much books, that is more and more books in the library, and to help him to learn the Max first of all. As a matter of fact, every day, in every way, that little elf was a nag. What do you mean by nag? That is a one who troubles someone all the time by complaining or asking them to do something. That is like you, how you are in the childhood days. The same thing here. Patrick was working harder than ever and was it a drag. What do you mean by drag? Something dull and uninteresting. He was not at all interested in doing his works. He was staying up nights, had never felt so weary, was going to school with his eyes puffed and blurry. Finally, the last day of school arrived. The elf was free to go. Why he was free? That is, he was going to complete his 35 days task given by the Patrick. So far, homework there was no more. So he quietly and shyly slipped out the back door. What do you mean slyly, that is the secretly, that is he was going to complete his task what is given by Patrick. Patrick got his A's. His classmates were amazed. That is his classmates, his friends was amazed on seeing Patrick's homework. His teachers smiled and were full of praise. What about his parents? They wondered what had happened to Patrick. He was now the model kid. That is a child. Kid means it is a child. Cleaned his room, did his course, was cheerful, never rude, like he had developed a whole new attitude. See, compared to the Patrick that is the previous 35 days ago, he has got a complete change in his life, that he has completed his homework. Everybody, that is his classmates, his teachers and his parents were appreciated him a lot. You see, in the end, Patrick still thought he didn't make that tiny man do all his homework. That is why he is thinking that in that time itself, he doesn't do his homework by himself, that only the tiniest man has done the homework. But it is wrong. But I will share a secret. That is, our author is sharing a secret here, just between you and me. It wasn't the elf. Patrick had done it himself. See, the Patrick is thinking by himself that he has done his homework. But what is the main thing? The Patrick, he done his homework by himself. Not the tiniest man. The tiniest man doesn't know anything. That is the maths or addition, subtraction, anything else. He bothered. He asked Patrick to bring him books from the library. And he shared everything with him. And he guided, get help from the Patrick. And finally the homework was done by Patrick. But the Patrick is thinking in his mind that he is not completed his homework. Only his homework was completed by the tiniest man. Dear children, you have to do the homework by yourself. This story conveys the message that self-help is the best help. We should suppose for some more times we can get help from others. We have to first try. If it is not, we can get help from others or we can succeed by ourselves. Thank you.